Hello everyone, myself Aursang SV. In today's session, I am going to explain Smith trigger circuit using IC555. At the end of today's session, students will be able to explain operation, circuit diagram, output signal waveform, and hysteresis of Smith trigger circuit using IC555. These are the contents of my today's presentation. The Smith trigger is a wave shaping circuit that converts any kind of periodically changing AC signal waveform to square wave signal or pulse wave signal. It is also known as a squaring circuit since its output is always a square wave signal. It is a fast operating voltage level detector or comparator. When the input voltage rises above or falls below certain upper threshold voltage level or lower threshold voltage level respectively, the output signal rapidly changes from high to low state and low to high state. Now this figure shows the circuit diagram for a Smith trigger circuit using IC555, in which the input signal is applied to pin number 6 and 2 through coupling capacitor, and output is taken from pin number 3. Pin 4 and 8 are shorted and connected to plus VCC, and here the two internal comparator inputs, like non-inverting input of comparator 1, that is a threshold input, pin number 6, and inverting input of comparator 2, that is a trigger input, pin number 2, are tied together and externally biased at 1/2 VCC using external resistors RA and RB. Resistor RA is connected between pin 6 and plus VCC, and resistor RB is connected between pin 2 and ground. Pin number 1 is grounded, pin 5 is grounded through 0.01 microfarad capacitor to avoid any noise problem as shown in figure 1. Now let us discuss the working of the Smith trigger circuit using IC555. The input AC signal, like a sinusoidal voltage signal, is applied commonly to pin 6 and 2 through capacitor C. The capacitor, that is a coupling capacitor, used for the isolation of input AC signal and DC signal present in the circuit. The internal comparator 1 changes its output at 2/3 VCC, and comparator 2 changes its output at 1/3 VCC of input periodically changing AC signal. The bias provided by the resistor RA and resistor RB, which is 1/2 VCC, that lies between these two threshold or reference voltage levels. Therefore, the input sinusoidal wave signal of sufficient amplitude, that is magnitude larger than 2/3 VCC minus 1/2 VCC, that is 1/6 of VCC, exceeding the threshold levels, makes the internal flip-flop of IC555 to alternately set and reset. The final output of IC555 timer alternately switches between high state and a low state. High state output equals high voltage level and low state output equals lower voltage level. Thus, the square wave signal is produced at the timer output. The frequency of output square wave signal will be same as that of input sine wave signal or any kind of periodically changing AC signal. There is no occurrence of a frequency division in the output signal as shown in figure 2. Now this figure shows figure number 2, output waveforms. The upper waveform is the input signal given to a Smith trigger circuit using IC555, so that is a sine wave signal, and the lower waveform is for the output signal from Smith trigger circuit using IC555. As the input sinusoidal signal crosses a 2/3 VCC voltage level, the output switches from high to low state. Again, when input sine wave signal falls below a 1/3 VCC voltage level, again the output of Smith trigger circuit changes from low state to high state. So at 2/3 VCC, output switches from high to low. At 1/3 VCC, the output switches from low to high. And this is periodically repeated. So the input sine wave signal is converted into a square wave signal at the output of a Smith trigger circuit. Now students should pause video here and think over this question and then continue. State UTP and LTP voltage levels for Smith trigger using IC555. UTP stands for upper triggering point voltage level and LTP stands for lower triggering point voltage level. Now this figure shows a hysteresis curve for Smith trigger circuit. It is a graph of output voltage versus the input voltage. So it shows the variation of output voltage in response to variation of the input voltage. As long as the input voltage is below UTP level, the output is high. When input signal just crosses UTP voltage level, the output switches to low voltage level. Again, when the input signal becomes less than LTP level, again output switches to high state. The figure 3 shows a hysteresis curve for Smith trigger circuit. It is a graph of output voltage VO versus the input voltage Vin. The hysteresis is caused in Smith trigger due to two different threshold voltage level or reference voltage level. The output triggering or trip points are defined as the two distinct values of input signal voltage at which the output of changes the state. The upper triggering point, that is UTP, has a value UTP equal to a 2/3 VCC. When input signal voltage just exceeds upper triggering point voltage level, that is a 2/3 VCC, the output signal switches from high voltage level to low voltage level. So that is a lower triggering point, LTP. So LTP has value LTP equal to 1/3 VCC volts. So the output remains in low state until the input signal falls below lower triggering point. So that is 1/3 VCC. The difference between the triggering points is the hysteresis, H, or the lagging of lower threshold voltage from upper threshold voltage is known as hysteresis. It is given as H equal to UTP minus LTP. So using this, we can calculate hysteresis voltage. So that is for Smith trigger using IC555, it is a 2/3 VCC minus 1/3 VCC volts. So hysteresis voltage is equal to 1/3 VCC. H is a dead zone of a Smith trigger. Dead zone in the sense, as long as the input signal is within the range of 2/3 VCC to 1/3 VCC, the output of Smith trigger circuit will not change. When the input signal goes outside this dead zone, the output switches from high state to low state or low state to high state. So this hysteresis is desirable in Smith trigger because it prevents a noise signal from causing a false triggering. So these are the references for my today's presentation. Thank you.